Hey everybody, this is Devin with HDpiano.com, and I'm coming at you today with the new Ed Sheeran track. It is called Castle on the Hill, and it's a real pump-up number. It kind of reminds me of Mumford and Sons. It's got some, you know, it's at 135 BPM. That's like the classic stomp your feet tempo. Just, let's do this. So it's got tons of energy, and I'm excited to share the piano part with you guys. That said, there isn't much of a piano part in the song, so I've kind of just made one up. So we're going to check out the main riff, which is going to work over the verse and the chorus with some subtle variations. So check it out. Here we go. Loop this for four bars. One, two, three. We go into the pre-chorus at that particular moment, which I'll be teaching in the next video, part two, which can be found over at hdpiano.com, home of the hybrid piano lesson. This song will be broken up into five parts. I'll give you a brief rundown here. Main riff, what we're working on right here. The pre-chorus. The chorus is included in the main riff. And then there's the bridge. And then there's the piano. The only time we actually really hear obviously, oh, that's piano, is also in the bridge, and it's kind of like the quiet breakdown chorus leading into the final chorus, and that's going to have its own little video so I can teach that part and help you guys get that perfect. And then, video number five, I play through the whole song. So that's all available over at hdpiano.com, but let's get right to it, all right? I'm excited. So, it's cool. We've got this looping guitar thing going on. I'm curious if any of you guys have ever messed with a loop pedal. It's kind of fun. I use some effects for one of my keyboards. I have an old Wurlitzer keyboard, and you know I have like a loop pedal, some delays and stuff. So yeah, it's kind of unusual. You usually associate that with guitar type of stuff, but if any of you have one of those, maybe you could try it out. But basically, you're just creating a vibe with A, D, and A. Okay, and I thought about trying to replicate what the guitar is doing, but it just sounds a little messy on piano. You know, it's a very busy rhythm. So I simplified it to just eighth notes. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one. Okay? So we're doing D and A. Middle C is right here, by the way. D and A, alternating with a lower A with the thumb. So one and two and three and four and... just get that under your fingers. All right. And up to tempo. It's like this. Just try and stay relaxed. Be cool. All right. So we're going to leave that be for a minute and check out this bass line. So after four bars of just the right hand, we bring in the left hand. And we start on the downbeat. One, two, three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one. So it's a lot of upbeats. So even though we start on a downbeat, eventually we're pretty much just doing all upbeats, save for a couple downbeats only on the B minor chord. So that might sound a little confusing right off the bat, but I will break it down for you. So downbeats are 1, 2, 3, 4. Upbeats are anything between the downbeats. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the bass line is down, down, up, up, up. Down, 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 up, oh, up, up. Well, that's tougher than I thought. Anyways. Down, down. Up, up, up. All right, so we're going from a D, a measure of D major, and then at the end of that measure, use the F sharp to lead into the G, which is the next measure. So we have a measure of G, and then that immediately lands us in the next measure on B minor, and then the next measure is A major. And at the end of the A major measure, we play a C sharp to get us back up into the D. All right, so. These are just the notes. So you can make sure you have their order memorized before we add too many fancy rhythms. But let's slow it down. Everything's better when you slow it down. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and down. Two and three and four and one and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one. All right, so I would recommend just playing along with me, because it's a slow tempo. And then once you get that, then turn on the record and play along to the man himself. And once you feel like you really have that rhythm internalized, then we can even take a look at the finer details. For example, every other B is either on a downbeat or anticipated. So it begins on a downbeat. So when we get to the B, it's on a downbeat. So 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and down. Right? Notice that B happened on the downbeat, beat 1 of the third measure. But the second time, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2. It was and 1, and 2. Whoops. And 1, and 2. Right? So it's anticipated every other cycle. And I thought that was cool to, you know, kind of discover that. And I wanted to share that with you guys because it's obviously they're paying attention to those little things, as you would expect with such a, you know, well-produced track. So that's our bass line. Time to add the two. So sometimes the bass line will be hitting with the top two notes on downbeats. Or it'll be hitting with the thumb when it happens on upbeats. So if we go real slow, everything should line up. One and two and three and four and one and two, three and four and one and two and 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 three and four and one and two.
So I did two cycles, but the verse is four cycles, and the chorus is two cycles. So
let's check out the chorus then. If you're comfortable with that, you can slowly start to speed it up. Tempo. All right, but at that tempo, you might as well just play along with Ed. Okay, so let's take a look at the chorus. We're going to take what we've done, and you'll notice there's all this space in the frame here. Why am I not using it? Well, that's because in the chorus, I'm just going to spread out and get comfortable with the piano and really make this chorus sing. So we're going to double the bass line in the left hand. So nothing's going to change. The pattern's going to remain the same, but it's going to be a lot of moving your hand. Play the same right hand pattern up the octave, and we're gonna bash it out a little harder, right? I forgot to mention that this, when it's down in this octave, you don't wanna hit it too hard, right? It's the verse, it's chill, but when we get up here to the chorus, you can really put some weight into it. So, it sounds like this. chorus ends with two bars of D, holding the D in the left hand, and pedaling this right hand loop for two bars. And then we go back to the verse. Okay. So that's all we're going to check out in this video. Let's see. Is there anything else I wanted to say? I think we covered it all. I'm excited about the... I had to kind of make a pianistic part for the pre-chorus. So that's going to be in the next video. I'm excited to jump into that. But yeah, you should be good to go. That's going to get you through the verse and the chorus, which is a good 60-70% of the song. So I hope you liked it. And we'll see you over at the next one. And while you're here, I just want to mention you can reach out to us via Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. We're all on all those platforms as HDpiano. Give us a like on Facebook, and on Instagram we do a cool thing where if you play one of these songs, we can repost it and share it with our followers. And on Twitter, that is where we want your requests. So if you're already thinking like, oh geez, this is cool, I want to get another, I see they don't have this song that I really want, well, head on over to Twitter and using the hashtag HDRequests, let us know what you want. That helps us organize everything and keep track. So we'll see you out there on the social medias. And we'll see you over at hdpiano.com for the next lessons. All right. Thanks, guys. This is Devin. Tune in up.